So if the sole of the club skips off the turf, then I'm going to get brilliant contact with the golf ball. So I'm going to give myself some nice momentum and then whip it along the turf to make it skip. And boy, oh boy, did that feel amazing. Look at that. Boom! Moo!
That's long.
That was just like, wow.
Yeah.
Hey everyone, Shawn Sav Mu at your service once again. And today, guys, we're talking about width in the backswing, which all of us have a ton of. And we're going to give you this awesome drill that's going to create amazing width. For those of you who are collapsed in the backswing, those of you who feel you have too much of an overswing, we have the perfect drill for you to do, and it's skipping stones on water. You don't want to miss this show. But of course, we want you to be a member of Wisdom and Golf family. It's free. Just subscribe to our channel.
Leave a comment or question down below and give us a thumbs up.
And also hit that bell so you don't miss any future videos.
A little context for many of you who are trying to keep, you know, the arms connected. And you're trying to keep that armpit connected to your rib cage in the backswing. That really doesn't bode very well for any other discipline except for what you perceive as a good discipline for golf. Because we basically see these over-the-top swings and elbows sticking out, and we feel the need to correct that and connect the armpit to the rib cage, and now we're throwing like T-Rex. We just stepped out of the frying pan and we dove right into the fire. We don't want any part of that. And as far as, you know, for those of you who are collapsing at the top of the backswing and getting too, you know, accordion-like, we have one drill that'll fix it once and for all. I'm going to give you the drill for the right-hand dominant person playing right-handed golf or the four-hander, and that's skipping a stone. And then Sav is going to show you a fantastic, for those of you who are lead-hand dominant, so if you're left-handed playing right-handed golf, or if you're right-handed playing left-handed golf, like lefty Phil Mickelson, there is a wonderful drill that's going to help you for that. Don't go away. We're going to show you that right after I show you this one, all right? So if I'm skipping a stone on water, I want to send that stone into the screen. Notice how wide my arm is. You can see it from back here and from down the line. So when I want to throw it, you'll notice that the elbow snaps forward. See how my brain's got to go get the ground, use the ground to get my body out of the way, and you notice how that elbow now is in front of me and in front of my hand. So it's wide, narrow, wide. And we never have to think about that one, do we? So we just throw that stone to skip it on water. So if I do the same thing with my golf club, so now imagine if I hold my club with just one arm, the sole of the club is the skipping stone. It's tied to a nice extension, like a 3 foot long shaft, and goes into my right hand. So I'm gonna go wide, and I'm looking to skip the sole of the club along the ground into that direction. You can flip it over if you feel that it's a little too heavy and hold it like a sword. Notice now if I've got a bamboo shoot and I'm slashing a sword through that bamboo shoot, notice how that elbow comes in first, then the hand, then the blade, then the tip of the blade. So when I'm throwing a stone on water, elbow leads, and you notice how the last thing to come through is my index finger. So if you've got a really good grip on the club, notice how that index finger, that trigger finger, is nicely hooked on to the club. And now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna throw the club underhand like a shortstop throwing to first base. and I'm slinging that club head along the ground to make it skip off the turf. So if the sole of the club skips off the turf, then I'm gonna get brilliant contact with the golf ball. So I'm gonna give myself some nice momentum and then whip it along the turf to make it skip. And boy, oh boy, did that feel amazing. Look at that. Boom! Moo!
That's long.
That was just like, wow.
Yeah.
I'm ecstatic with that shot. That'll be the only shot I hit for you guys today, right? So, one and done. Focused on whipping the club along the surface of the ground in the direction I want to start the ball. And the only way to do that, there's no way I could do it from here. And there's no way that I could do it from here. The only way is from here. Notice how wide that arm is away from the body. Not trying to keep the elbow to my side. Not trying to keep the armpit to my side. Just stays wide. And I'm going to whip it wide in the direction of my target. So now let's look at our resident female lefty. And let's see how much width we can get in your backswing if you're dominant from the lead hand and you can't skip a stone with that. See, with if I'm a lefty, I can pretend to skip that stone, but it's not gonna be pretty. So for those of you, this is important. Now, Sav plays some pretty good tennis. She has a really good backhand in tennis. And if she played baseball, you would bat from the left side. And in golf, you're a lefty. So a really good drill for her, because she's right hand dominant, hold your sword in your lead hand. Very nice. So imagine you got a bamboo shoot and you want to slash through that shoot. So do a backswing. Look at this, you guys. Look at her whole backside facing the target. And from your angle, notice how her hand is right in front of her body. This is an unbelievable position. And don't worry about the elbow. You'll notice the elbow's got a little bit of a bend in it. But as soon as she goes into the slash, it straightens out all on its own.
Yeah.
So you're feeling that you can use the weight of that arm sword unit to slash through.
Yeah.
Let's see a couple of those. Do the sword. And you're going to slash it to the, you're doing a draw here?
Yeah.
So show me a draw slash, that's it. Notice how her head stays behind as she's slashing it through, because you're slashing to the left of that intermediate point, right?
Yeah.
So do you all see how her head was staying back there? That was phenomenal. So she's hitting a nice draw into that flag. Nice. What a shot. So do one more of the drill. Yeah. And so realize, do the backswing and stop. I mean, the width only comes if you turn, right? You feel like you're turning your whole back to the target. So because you're turning fully, notice how that lead hand's coming behind the ball and the whole backside's facing the target. You get natural width.
Yeah.
So not only are you gonna get more heft coming through, more momentum coming through, but you also have more rotational momentum coming through.
Yeah.
And that's why she's hitting her 7-iron basically the same distance as me. I mean, what you hit that was 190 carry to my 195 carry. That's phenomenal.
Yes, it's downhill.
Phenomenal, 22 feet downhill. Give me a break, this is La Jolla. Right, we're playing Torrey Pines. So Munashe, once again, is right in between the two. So he's ambidextrous, so we're gonna have him skip some stones and we're gonna have him slash the sword. We'll have him do both and then hit a shot. All right, Moo.
All right, so
let's see you start with a skipping of the stone. Take that in your left hand.
Okay.
Let's see you skip a couple toward the flag.
Okay.
Nice. You do like the overhand better in that one, right?
Yeah.
So you notice even when he's trying to skip the stone, he's still going kind of overhand on that.
Yeah.
So the submarine pitch, you do better right hand. Let me see your right hand pitch.
Okay.
Yeah. So you do skip a stone better with the right hand.
Yeah, that's just how weird I am.
Okay. You're a beauty, man. Come on, look how beautiful this man is. So take your club now.
Yeah.
And let's see this, pretend that's your bamboo shoot coming up.
Okay.
And let's give it that nice slash. This is something you do really, really well. All right. Now do it lead hand.
All right.
Just like Sav, that's it. So turn your hole back. Boom, look at that release. One of the things that many of you are having a hard time doing with the shot, mm-hmm. when you're skipping a stone on water, the sole of the club stays along the ground nice, right?
Yeah.
So to emphasize this, what you're gonna do, we have these button tees that we use so we don't pierce our screen, but you can put two tees along the ground about 4 inches apart. So you see these?
Yeah.
So what Mu's gonna do is he's gonna send those two tees into the screen, mm-hmm. with some nice momentum. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
So you'll notice how he had to stay along the surface of the ground for a nice long period of time.
Yeah.
So if we put those two tees right beside and we put the ball next to the first tee,
okay.
right?
Yeah.
So there's your two tees that you're gonna sweep in that direction.
Yeah.
Can you picture how that's gonna work?
Yeah.
Good. So stay along the ground in that direction.
Nice. I was compressed, but face was a little closed.
Okay, try that again. That swing actually looked pretty good.
I drew a lot. Okay.
All right. So along the ground, over that intermediate point.
Felt better.
Not bad. Get down. What club are you hitting, man?
8-iron.
8-iron, okay.
Yeah, so probably 9 would be safe here, right?
Yes, I'd say 9-iron would be a safer club.
Okay.
Do one more with a 9-iron.
Okay.
Oh, does that ever sound good? Wow. Holy mackerel.
Okay, let's...
You're there. So if you're going to draw it in,
yeah,
start it toward the bunker on the left.
Okay.
Look at that.
That's on the flag.
There's the shot.
Yeah. It's a little thin, but...
Yeah, thin
but
that's to win.
That's the flavor, though.
Yeah, exactly. So see how that cuts down on your side spin?
Big time, yeah.
All right. That is amazing. What a shot. Right on, Mu.
Thanks, Sean.
So you see how we use those tees to straighten things out, to keep you along the ground.
Yeah.
To stay along the ground, you can't come down from something that's super steep and super collapsed.
Yeah.
If you collapse against your body, you got no other choice but to slam down.
Right.
So when you're really nice and wide in the backswing, then you can stay along the surface of the ground.
Yeah.
And now you're moving beautifully in the direction of your target.
Yeah.
So we hope you enjoyed that. Get wide. See you next week.